The reason number six is the need of security. The need of security is the main and the most important thing, the most important need that every child needs in his childhood. If your parents did not provide you with a sense of security, if you did not feel safe, if you did not feel that your life is protected, if your parents did not tell you that they will protect you, they will be on your side no matter what, then in 99% you can't relate to this reason. If you don't feel that your life is secured and protected, then it can lead to low self-esteem, low self-confidence, inability to protect yourself, inability to create the healthy boundaries. You have problems with accepting your body or some part of your body. The child with insecurity issues will develop a trust issues later in the relationship. Sexual problems in the relationship also related to this point. And in the mother's womb, it was a nice, safe place. But when a child was born, he experienced a tremendous stress. And a little baby, an infant, he does not know how to communicate. So he used cry as his communication mechanism. When a baby is cold, he cries. When a baby needs attention, he cries. When a baby is scared, he cries. When he feels pain, he cries. So baby cries all the time. And often mothers automatically assume that if baby is crying, then he is hungry. The first thing that mothers want to do is to feed the baby. So they give food first, and then if baby does not stop, then they will try to figure out what is happening, what other reason might be for his crying. So this is your eating mechanism, right? This is how you use food. So if your mother could not understand your desires during your childhood, then now you eat every time when you feel sad, stressed, scared, pain, anything, any discomfort, you need food. So here is tip number six. Before you go and grab food, ask yourself, what do you really feel? What is your real desire at this moment? Are you sad? Are you angry? Are you tired? Or are you hungry? Because hunger is only one of the reasons why baby is crying. And there are a lot of different reasons why baby can be crying. And you need to go back to your childhood. You need to reprogram this mechanism, and you need to learn how to identify those feelings. And it's very hard. I want to be honest with you. It's very hard to do on your own. And I recommend working with your therapist, psychologist, with a support group. But if you want to do it on your own, it's also possible. It's extremely hard, but possible. You have to ask yourself, what am I feeling right now? Every time when you want to have something and you know that you already had your lunch, breakfast, dinner, ask yourself, what am I feeling right now? And again, on the 8 weeks of healing the inner child, the first week, the very first week, we're gonna talk about this mechanism. And this week is called Return to Paradise. And we're gonna do an exercise that's called the Divine Child. And we're gonna learn how to connect, how to understand your inner child, how to understand what do you really need, and how to understand your true desires, your emotions. And then we're gonna do an exercise which is called the Magical Lake. A magical lake is a symbol of a mother's womb. And we're gonna return to that place where you can get anything that you want. The place that which called paradise. So you will fulfill your child with a sense of security, with the love, with the freedom and happiness. And then we're gonna do an exercise turtle, which will help you to feel protected. This is extremely important. If you did not receive protection in your childhood, then in 99% of time, your eating addiction is because of that. And the turtle exercise will help you to get back to this secured place and to feel strong protection by the turtle shell. You will be able to create a secured place within yourself. And on the 7th week of the webinar, we're gonna also work with the boundaries, how to say no, how to protect your boundaries, and we're gonna work on your self-esteem. Because if you don't feel protected, then you cannot say no. Then people can use you, abuse you, and if you cannot say no, if you don't know how to defend yourself, instead of creating those boundaries, you're going to the refrigerator or you're going to the fast food restaurant and you buy something fat, sweet for you, for yourself, and you're trying to suppress those feelings. And we're gonna do an exercise where you're gonna learn how to say no. I will actually give you specific phrases, what to use, how to say it, when to say it, with whom to say it, because there are people are different, and with different people we use different phrases. And I will teach you how to find an exit in any situation. It's gonna be an exercise which called five ways to go. So five ways to find an exit in any situation. Reason number 7,